Mr. Piper, there's a big lack of communication here, because when I said that I made wrestling, when I said that I own wrestling and I control wrestling, now that I really think about it, I remember that you and I were running neck and neck.
Why don't you shut up for a second? It's my turn.
Be careful.
I am not here to represent the WCW, the NWA, the SPCA, the SOB, although I can be one SOB when I want to be.
Be careful. Be real careful.
Yeah, I made a lot of money being real careful. I tell you something there, Charlie Brown. You've been saying that if it wasn't for you, professional wrestling wouldn't be what it is today. Boy, do I got news for you. I come to you for a reality check there, partner. I come because, you see, I'm just as big an icon in this sport as you are. I am just as big a Hollywood movie star as you are. You know, let me have my piece, because I'm shooting with this one, folks. I don't care, man. I'm a multi-millionaire, too. I started fighting pro when I was 15 years old. I've had over 6,000 professional matches. I've been stabbed 3 times. Who?
Hello. Sit back, Sprout. Sit back.
Whoa, let's cut.
Wait a second.
No, no, no.
Shut your mouth.
Let's cut to
the
point. Hang
on. Let me have the floor. I've caught your act. Where were you when I was 15 years old, taking on all comers in a garage? Where were you, playing the bass guitar in Tootsie's Bar and Grill? Huh? Where were you? Shut up, man.
You know something, Piper? I'm going to call a spade a spade. We ran together. The heck with a backstory. We fought together. And I don't have a problem with you, because, okay, as you've been out in Hollywood making all those movies and becoming a multimillionaire, I have to think back and give the devil his due. We ran neck and neck.
No, no, not yet. Not yet. Not yet. Not yet. You remember WrestleMania? Tell me something. If I hadn't knocked out Mr. T, took on the New York City Police Department, chased Dick Clark back, had my way with Liberace, if they didn't hate me so much, you think they would have been cheering you so much? Shut up, I ain't finished. Do you know what bothers you? I'm the only guy you have never been able to beat.
He's right.
And I'll tell you something else. You're going to admit it. I am as big an icon in this sport, and whether you want to say it or not, you at least have the guts to put your hand out and you shake my hand and you admit that it isn't you that brought all these people here. It's all these people here that made you. Now, I'll be glad to.
Let me tell you something, Piper. We've had wars to settle the score, which didn't get settled. And I thought you took off with your family and were at peace with yourself. But now that I see you face to face, me being the honest man that I am, yes, I admit, you're just as big a superstar as I am.
Then straighten up.
Oh, by the way, Piper, on the way out, when you go to the bathroom, you're supposed to squat in that one.
Wow. Huh. Well, I'll tell you what.
Let me tell you something.
No, I've had enough. Let me tell you something. You're messing with Hollywood Hogan and NWO. You step back into my world, I can still see you've got the makeup on your face, Piper. And the way it goes, now that I look in your eyes, maybe we need to have the war that didn't settle the score. Your day's coming. Yeah, I want to know something.
I'm the reason you got no hair, and what you gonna do about it?
Your day's coming, Piper.